Hey guys.
Hi.
Today we thought it'd be cool to talk about societies and clubs that are available in St. Andrews. People have been asking us about the extracurriculars that are available here. Mm-hmm. So we thought it'd be a good idea to talk about our experiences with them, because I think together we probably covered a lot of bases. Kiana has actually entered the gym. I have, but only for an exam.
That's amazing. I'm not really a sports person. I like the gym.
She says repping that.
Yeah, we got the same sport going on. But I do riding, horse riding. I go to the gym a lot, which I'm not like in any gym clubs because there's stuff like weightlifting club. So there's a massive sports fair at the beginning of every academic year. You can go and talk to different clubs and sign up. All of them, I think, have a competing team. There are so many diverse sports as well. Like you can go all the way from the normal stuff, rugby, hockey, football, all that stuff, to more niche things such as like capoeira and...
Do they offer that here?
Yeah.
I think every sport has a competing team.
Yeah.
But also there's also like non-competing teams if you just want to be involved in team sport but don't necessarily want to be like in a competition.
So like I'm not on the team, I just ride for fun.
And then also every sport society also has a couple of times a week just like flexi hours in which you can just like turn up.
And see if you like it.
Yeah.
I know two of my friends, they tried out boxing and now one of them's competing in the next show, so...
That's cool. Sports allegedly are a good way of meeting people. No, they are.
Wednesday night is social night for all the sports societies.
So it's sinners.
Yeah.
Is what they call it.
Well, sinners only happens once a month.
Does it?
But yeah.
I literally know nothing about sport. This is so bad. I am not a person to represent this.
Sinners happens once a month. Each society, sports society, gets allocated a number of tickets. And if you're in the society, of course, you have the chance to buy the tickets. But the tickets get you access into 601. Which, not gonna lie, I'm not a big fan of sinners. Sometimes they'll have themes as well. So I know, like, there was one sinners that it was, like, pink theme. The sports societies mainly want to get you drunk. Like, very drunk.
Yeah, no, this is true. This is something I've heard.
I'm not lying about this. I've seen, like, hockey friends come back from...
Hockey, I think, actually is one of the worst ones. Honestly, if you're a hockey player and wanting to do hockey at St. Andrews, be careful, because I've heard, like, bad initiation stuff.
Yeah.
They go really hard on, like, social events and stuff.
At, like, one event, they had to dress up as, like, leopards.
Mm.
And then one of our friends came back to halls, like, absolutely trashed.
Yeah.
And I have a video of her, but we're not going to be showing that.
It's a big commitment, really.
We have, like, home games, but there are also a bunch of away games.
And, like, you could leave, like, the whole weekend or whatever.
Mainly they are in Scotland, though. They've done, like, Aberdeen, Dundee, Edinburgh before. Like, Edinburgh.
But then if you're, like, in, like, the triathlon teams or, like, running teams or anything, then you, like, go all over the country.
Oh, that's
right. Like, I know people who've gone down, like, way down south to do it.
Yeah. For me, riding can be quite pricey, I'm not gonna lie to you.
All societies you pay membership for.
Yeah, that's very true.
So, like, membership can range from anything from, like, a couple of pounds to a lot. Yeah, so sports are a lot just because you pay membership for the club, you pay membership for the gym. But like if you have membership to society, then you also get discounts. You're gonna do music stuff.
I mean, I'm part of music society because I'm in symphony orchestra. That is also a big commitment, I think, being a part of music soc, because there are different parts of music soc. So you can have like ensemble groups. The symphony's quite big. We have two orchestras. And then there are also, obviously, you can take individual lessons as well if you want.
Mm-hmm.
We practice for 2.5 hours every week. And then we have a concert every semester, so I'd say it's quite a big commitment, but it does keep you practicing.
In first year, I got involved with like some singing societies and stuff. So St. Andrews offers a lot of like different choirs, a lot of different a cappella groups, a lot of singing groups. In first year, I got involved in like musical theatre in first semester when I was actually like wanting to do stuff. Now you get old and you're just lazy. St. Andrews hits and you realise you cannot do all these societies.
Yeah, that's very true.
You have to do a lot of time commitment in. Like, in first year, I had to put a lot of commitment in for, like, theatre and stuff.
Oh, but you're part of the same.
Well, yeah, but even before that, like, when I just did acting in first semester, it was a lot. Like, I had an entire month where it'd be, like, a rehearsal every night. Yeah, so the same. Let's talk about that. There's a lot of writing opportunities, I think, in St. Andrews, actually. So the same, which is the largest one, which is, like, the student newspaper I do. Am I still a part of that? I don't know. They might throw me out. Who knows? I haven't written in a long time. But no, I do that. So last year I was their theatre editor, which was a really good way of getting free tickets to everything.
Yeah, but he kept having to go to shite plays.
Yeah, I went to... A lot of my friends were in there.
Do you remember the one that you sent me of, like, recording of?
Oh my gosh, that was appalling. That was literally appalling. So it was great because I got to have, like, creative license and write all of these reviews, a lot of which didn't get published because apparently they were too critical and too hard.
Oh my word.
So I would recommend that if you want free tickets to stuff, work for the Saint.
Yeah.
Because like if you're like if you work for like their theatre section, you get free tickets to any plays you want.
I want to work for their like events.
Honestly, their features section, which cover events, are so good because for that writers get free tickets to balls, parties, so many different events, to fashion shows. It's brilliant. And all you have to do is like write an article every couple of weeks. So I would recommend that if you're interested in like student journalism or
that's not
just
like
free
a massive
stuff.
Commitment.
I mean, it was theatre was a massive commitment.
Okay, for you, yeah.
Creative societies.
Oh yeah.
There's so many creative societies. Like dance is huge.
Oh, massive. And they have competitions and they go like all over. They had one in Durham.
And their showcase is so good every year as well.
Yeah. They do like a massive showcase with all these different types of dance in it. From like hip hop all the way to ballet and like Highland dancing.
Yeah.
Tap dancing, everything.
It's really impressive.
And we had K-pop dancing as well.
Like there's a lot of creative outlets for, at this university if you want to do that. So let's dancing. There's some art societies.
And my grandpa's calling. Hold on.
Are we doing this mid-film?
خیلی مشغول بودم این چند روز آخر. بله تموم شد. تموم شد. Sorry about that. Oh, my grandma said hi, by the way.
Elsewhere in creative outlets. What do we have? We have like comedy sock. Also, there's basically a society for every subject.
Oh yeah, there is.
So you get to meet people in other years in your subject as well, I guess.
I've been to a history sock event.
Yeah, I went to their garden party. Get involved in societies because then at like the end of like semesters and stuff, they always have like good dinners and balls and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, and the thing is, it's really good like price for what you want.
It really is.
Because you'll pay like something like £25. And get a meal that's worth like 78.
Yeah, it's such a good price.
Because they give you starter, main, and dessert.
Yeah, basically in St. Andrews, there's probably a society for everybody.
There's like Quidditch society as well.
Yeah, do you know that? My sister's face when we arrived on the first day and looked around and people were playing Quidditch.
Oh, they have a lot of like entrepreneurial societies.
Yeah, they do.
As well,
yeah.
Where like I know one year, I don't remember exactly what society it was, but the girl who came up with the company idea for Kabini Co.
Yeah.
Won that.
Yeah.
And that's how she managed to open Kabini Co. Oh, they have stuff for lawyers as well. There's law reviews.
Yeah, there's so many societies also for just like future jobs. Mm-hmm. And like it's a great way to network. It's just us name dropping so many societies to you right now. Basically, go on the union website. And you'll find a massive list of all the societies. I think there's like 100 or maybe more.
There's 150 different clubs.
Okay, so there's 150 societies. I know so many people and I was one of those people and I literally signed up for so many different things and then didn't end up either going to half of them or if I did go, I committed myself too early.
Oh, also for those of you interested in postgraduate stuff, there's a postgraduate society as well.
Also some halls have their own societies as well. Right. So like inter-hall stuff. So there's inter-hall sport competitions in which like halls compete against
each
other.
Yeah, I never did that.
No,
I
went to watch some. Sally's had its own book club. Sally's has its own library.
So refined. Why was I not
halls have like their own groups as well to like get involved with stuff.
Thank you for watching, everyone.
Yeah, thanks guys.
Let us know in the comments below if you have any other questions. Give this video a like and subscribe if you have not already.
Right, let's have lunch because I am starving.
Okay.